नमस्ते, वेलकम टू द थर्ड डे ऑफ आइडस इंटरनेशनल ऑनलाइन फेस्टिवल सीजन 2, पावर्ड बाय ओम स्कूल ऑफ डांस केरला अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ डॉक्टर हर्षन सेबास्टियन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी एक्सटेंड माय ग्रैटिट्यूड टुवर्ड्स डॉक्टर हर्षन हु अप्रोच्ड आइडा, हु अप्रोच्ड डॉक्टर रतीश बाबू एंड मायसेल्फ फॉर डूइंग दिस फेस्टिवल ऑनलाइन. And he was excited that upon the idea that I suggested to feature each dance form each day. Thank you to all of you who have been supporting us through and through these past 2 days, and looking forward to your support, your sharing to the future days. Today we will be presenting Odissi, my favorite dance form from the state of Orissa, a dance form that has achieved and attaining much popularity in today's time, all because of the contribution of great gurus who have worked hard to make this form a beautiful one. They've also been very successful in creating beautiful futuristic gurus who are really elevating the form with the concepts, and that is much more available in access to today's times. And one such guru that we have who's going to speak about Odissi is the direct disciple of Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra, is going to present and speak to you a few words about Odissi. Please welcome Guru Jhelum Paranjape from Mumbai. Dear friends, once again, welcome to the third day of AIDA International Festival. Do share, do support us. Enjoy the festival.
Namaste. I am Jhelum Paranjape, Odissi dancer, teacher and choreographer from Mumbai. I'm very happy about this festival that is happening, curated by Ratish Babu and Sandhya Manoj. And thank you, Sandhya, very much for taking me on board to talk about Odissi. Many of you may be knowing, but yet, I would like to tell you all that Odissi is the classical dance style from the eastern state of India, Orissa. Odissa has many temples strewn all over, and our dance Odissi, I would say, it's, one cannot say whether the sculptures of the temple came first or our dance came first. Because you can say that sculpture is dance frozen, or dance is when sculptures come alive. So that's like a conundrum, that what is Odissi. But Odissi has been mentioned in Bharata's Natya Shastra as the Odra Nritya. Like most of our Indian classical dance styles, Odissi also has a temple base. Odissi was initially danced in the temples by women known as Maharis. Many of you know the term Devadasi. In Odisha, they are called Maharis. Mahan Nari, the chosen woman to do seva or to serve the Lord, Lord Jagannath. And these Maharis always danced inside the temple. Their dance was never brought out of the temple. People, public in general, would never witness their dance. But various reasons are attributed to the decline of the dance of the Maharis. One of the major reasons that is given is when the Mughals reigned over India, these Maharis, because of their beautiful dance, they were forced to dance in the darbars of these kings. And for the Maharis, for them, their dance was a seva, was their service to Lord Jagannath. And when their service, this service to Lord Jagannath, was being pulled away, pulled out of the temples and taken into the courts of the kings, For the Maharis, it was blasphemy. They would rather die than do something like this. And so the Maharis started hiding. and not going to the temples to dance. And then this worried the scholars of those times, that if the Maharis do not dance, this beautiful dance style of our region will just vanish. What will happen? So then came the Gotipuas. Gotipua, Gotiepua, one boy. They were young boys who still hadn't grown a beard or a mustache, and these young boys, they were dressed like girls. They grew their hair, they pierced their ears and wore earrings, they pierced their nose and wore nose rings, dressed as women, made up as women or young girls, and they danced this dance. This dance was taught to the Gotipuas. So that was the first step that Odissi took from the temple precincts, out of the temple precincts, when it was performed by the Gotipuas. And then what happened was, these Gotipuas, young boys, as they grew up, when they became young men, they could no longer dress as young girls and dance. But they knew the dance, they had the qualities, they had the knowledge. So they started teaching this dance. They became the gurus. They became the gurus and spread this dance to those who wanted to learn it. And from these Gotipuas, the four main gurus who kind of revived Odissi, brought it to the stage it now is. I would take the four names of Guru Pankacharan Das, Guru Deva Prasad Das, Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra, and Guru Mayadhar Raut. These four men were really responsible for getting Odissi where it is now. I have learned from Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra, hence I will talk about his method of revival. He, along with Sanjukta Panigrahi, his Patashishya, his main student, travelled all over India, travelled out of India, spreading this dance style, making people aware that there is a classical dance style called Odissi. And I remember whenever we said to Guruji that it's because of you people that Odissi has become as popular as Bharatanatyam and Kathak. And then Guruji would say, don't praise us. You know, we just found a beautiful statue that was completely covered with dirt and dust. We couldn't see the beauty of the statue. The only thing we did was wipe out the dirt and dust from that statue and place it in front of the people in its total real beauty. That was how humble Kelucharan Mahapatra was. And I'm sure the other three gurus were and are the same, because I have not experienced them. But this is how Odissi, and I should tell you a little bit about the style, the grace. Odissi is very fluid, it's very fluid, like the waves on the shores of Puri, or like the palms that sway. Our body movement, our torso movement is very akin to that. Earlier I said that Odissi dance is the sculptures coming to life, or coming alive, or the sculptures are frozen dance. So there is a lot of interaction or connection between the sculptures and our dance. Literally so, because with our body movement we take certain poses, and if we freeze at that certain point, you can definitely find a sculpture in a temple that is akin to the posture that the Odissi dancer has taken. So that is Odissi for you. A beautiful, graceful, fluid, lyrical dance style of the eastern state Odisha from India. And Odissi took steps to come out of the temple First it was the Maharis, then it stepped out of the temple, then it became the Gotipuas, then it stepped further when the Gotipuas became the Gurus, then it stepped further when these Gurus taught women like us, and then it took a step further when Odissi came on the proscenium stage. So that is Odissi for y'all in brief. Thank you very much.
Our first performer for today is Maumita Ghosh. Maumita Ghosh has been trained in Odissi by Padma Shri Guru Srimati Madhvi Mudgal at the Gandharva Mahavidyalaya in Delhi. As a soloist, she has travelled and performed at prestigious venues in and out of the country. Empaneled with the ICCR and Doordarshan, she has given lectures and workshop demonstrations for IRCEN and SPIC MACE to generate art awareness among youth. She is awarded with Asian Peace Award, Shringar Mani, Nalanda Nritya Nipun, and Devadasi Award for Excellence in Odissi Dance. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Maumita Ghosh.
Namaskar. I begin my performance with Amangala Charan, Jagannath Ashtakam. This is a hymn to Lord Jagannath, who resides in the holy city of Puri with his sister Subhadra and brother Balabhadra. The verses say, "Once you appeared in the groves, in the banks of Kalindi, playing your sweet flute, enchanting the young maidens and drinking nectar from their lotus faces. Your feet were adorned by Lakshmi, Shambhu, Brahma, Indra and Ganesh. O Lord of the universe, appear in my vision, holding the flute in your left hand, head bedecked with peacock feather, tying the yellow silk around your waist. You give glances to your companions and have always revealed yourself through your leelas in Vrindavan. On the shore of the great ocean lies your temple atop the golden brilliant Nilachal Hills. There you reside with your brother and sister. O Lord, relieve us of pain, suffering, sorrow and sins." The last part of the composition shows the famous Rathayatra or the chariot procession, where the deities are taken out of the temple in a grand manner. The devotees are seen singing, dancing and playing various musical instruments in praise of the Lord. Set to rag Tilakamodandesh and Taal Ek Taali. Music composition is by Srimati Sunanda Patnayak and dance choreography is by Guru Srimati Madhavi Mudgal. Jagannath Ashtakam by Adi Guru Shankaracharya.
Thank you. Thank you.
Before going on to the second and my concluding item, I would like to thank IDA International and Sri Ratish Babuji to have organized this beautiful online platform for dancers as an endeavor to support and promote the arts at this very difficult time. I now present an Ashtapadi from the 12th century Sanskrit text Geet Govind, written by poet Jayadev, describing the eternal love tale between Radha and Krishna. Radha, who is as tender as a Vasanti flower, is wandering around the forest looking for Krishna. She is disquietedly anguished with burning and pain caused by Madana. At this point of time, her Sakhi comes and says the sweetest word to her. The tendrils of the clove plants are intertwined, and the soft scented wind is blowing from the Malaya mountains. The swarm of honeybees are buzzing, and the cuckoos are cooing over the thicket. Hari is dancing with the young maidens. Unrequited are the lovelorn people. The season heightens the joys and longings of the women folk who are distant from their lovers. The fragrance of the deer musk is spreading into the environment, and the king sugar flowers, the thorns of the king sugar flowers, resemble the sharp nails of Kamadeva, ready to tear the hearts of young people. Amidst all this, Hari, merrily roaming around the forest in the beautiful spring season. Vasante Vasanti Kusuma Sukumareira Avayavai. Music composition is by Sri Balakrishna Das. Dance choreography is by Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra. This piece is set to rag Adi Vasant and Tal, Triputa and Ektali, presenting Ashtapadi.
Thank you.
Our next performer for today is Sandhya Manoj. Sandhya Manoj, originally from Kerala, settled in Malaysia, is one of the leading Odissi solo dance artists in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. She has learned Odissi extensively under Guru Geeta Shankaran Lam, Guru Durgacharan Ranbir, and Guru Ratikant Mohapatra. Her renditions such as Radhe Radhe, Kaike, Dashamahavidya, Ardhanarishwara has been staged internationally, including countries like the US, New Zealand, Singapore, Bali, etc. She ventured a production, Padmanabhadasa, a first-time full production featuring Maharaja Swati Thirunal Kritis in Odissi. Her recent production, Prerna, was bringing the difficulties of an autistic child and mother onto stage through classical dance. She is also the founder of Manasa Yoga, one of the premier yoga schools in Malaysia. Apart from this, she does emceeing for corporate and cultural events, the most notable being the hosting of function honoring Prime Minister Narendra Modi on his visit to Kuala Lumpur. She is the president of NGO called Abhaya Malaysia that is focused on raising awareness about sexual abuse of children and helps victims recover through arts and yoga. She believes in imparting what she knows and experiences through her dance to her audience. For a performance is a mutual experience to be at the receiving end for all. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sandhya Manoj.
Namaste. Thank you to Dr. Ratish Babu, who is a friend, who is a co-director for this festival, Parav, for asking me to perform in this festival. Now, it is important that as a director of the festival that I refrain and I give the opportunity to someone else. But when Ratish ji asked me, why don't you perform as your sadhana at this juncture where everything is uncertain, performance, sadhana, everything goes through that stage of uncertainty, when he said, do it as how you love it and how you want to, just part of your aradhana, present it. And as we go back to our first identity, our baby steps, Dashamahavidya is one item that kick-started many things for me. I learnt it from Guru Durgacharan Ranveer, and Guruji was unbiased in imparting the essence of Dashamahavidya. And I dived deep along with my yoga guru Manoj Paimo into the aspects that can practically be imbibed in one's life. At this stage, when once again the uncertainty was right in front of me, I had to go back to find that grounding with the Param Durga, Dashamahavidya. Dashamahavidya comes in 10 forms of Devi. I'm not explaining, as I hope all of you are in line with it, but anytime you want to know more about it, please do directly message me. I will be more than happy to give my insights into it. But nevertheless, praying to that Kali, the one who is behind all that forces, in darkness, in the space, even behind the beating of the heart. The Tara, the one who knocks sense into our system. We say, I know, but until the experience strikes like a bang, that Tara Devi ignites that little insightful enlightenment. Then there is Shodashi, the Tripura Sundari, who has made the entire world so beautiful, and she is beautiful herself because she is in her teens. Anything she touches and feels and embraces is that absolute beauty, and that we are able to appreciate is through that Tripura Sundari, the Shodashi, the one who prayed to Lord Mahadeva. Each Devi imparts the essence of womanhood, the essence of teaching as to how to live in this world. The mala that she wears is none other than the severing of the ego, and also the ones that represents the Omkaram or the teachings of Sanskrit. Each Devi, like Bhairavi, she is asking whether the japa, the repetition of the teachings, or the Vedas, that is the teachings itself, which one are you going to outweigh? Both are equally important. Or the mother who is embracing you at all times and taking care of you no matter what you have done. Whatever you have done, I will be there as your mother, Bhuvaneshwari. That you have done so much of sadhana, so much of work and effort, but yet your ego stands up, and here Chinnamastal is saying cut off that identity that you consider yourself as I, me, mine, and let yourself to drink from your heart as you and I, that we want to follow our passion, we want to follow that heart. That is Chinnamasta allowing and severing her head, her ego, and letting the springs of her heart be fed to everyone, to her friends, to you, to me. After all this sadhana, what do we want? We want her. We don't want all these things that is of materialistic nature, but we want to be lifted to that higher self, and that is done by Matangi. She lifts literally from that lower state to the higher state for us to get elevated mentally, physically, and by all means. And last but not least is that Devi that we all go and pray completely with the form, the one who shines, the one who gives us darshanam in each temple, in each mother, in you. And dear friends, please embrace every Devi, as each one of them is within us and out there to teach us, to lift us, and to be with us.
झमक झम झम धाती खंडा धाती धर धरी झंड मुंडा जीह लह लह रुधिर तुंडा भगिड़ा गिड़ तक नत पसंडा भाक राली तब कराल रसना छुरुपु असुधिय लोल रसना इकस दसने स्पूट दसना महाम काम काल परिफिता विपरितर तिरे नुचरता धगिड़ा गिड़ तक धगिड़ा जण तक झमता झम झम झमता जण तक 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 ता तमा तक ता तमा तक ता तमा
प्रणामामि जगधात्री प्रणामामि जगधात्री। शेखर बल्लभा चंद्रशेखर बल्लभा कुसुम संकाशम दारिणी कुसुम पम चंद्ररेखा जटाजूट दिनेत्र नानालंकार सुभाग हीनत अटस्तनी बरान्युता मा धुमावती
kritaka dei dei kritaka dei dei kritaka dei takta ta kritaka dei dei kritaka dei kritaka dei kritaka dei kritaka dei ta kritaka dei dei kritaka dei kritaka dei kritaka dei kritaka dei dhage dha dha dhunna dha dha dhini dhage dha dha dhini dhage dhige dhage dhige dhage dha dha dhunni dha dha dhini dhage dha dha dhini dhage dhige dhage dhige dhage dha dha dhunni dha kritaka dha dhini 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 dha kritaka gati kanda a krta deita tak gati kanda gati kanda a krta deita tak gati kanda gati kanda a krta deita dinna a krta deita
madhi subhati mani mandap ratave सिंहासन परिगता परिपीतवन पीतांबर वरणमल विभूषितांगी देवी स्मरामि धृतमुद्गर वैरिजिहा
नमोस्तुते शंख चक्र गदा हस्ते महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते नमस्ते श्रीपीठे सुरा पूजित नमस्ते महामाई सुरा पूजित नमस्ते गरुड़ी कोला सुर नमस्ते गरुड़ी कोला सुर महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते शंख चक्र गदा भस्ते महालक्ष्मी नमोस्तुते नमस्ते महामाई सुर पूजिते नमस्ते महामाई सुर पूजिते नमस्ते महामाई सुर पूजिते नमस्ते महामाई सुर पूजिते दशमहाविद्याय नमो नमः ॐ दशमहाविद्याय नमो नमः ॐ दशमहाविद्याय नमो नमः
Our next performer for today is Miss Prachi Hota. Prachi Hota has 20 years of training in Odissi. She is trained under gurus like Guru Sri Hare Krishna Behra, Guru Srimati Y. Asha Kumari and Guru Srimati Kumkum Mohanty. She has been performing as a professional for the past 11 years and has performed in festivals of repute in India and abroad. She has been awarded with numerous honors and titles such as the National Scholarship from the Center for Cultural Research and Training, Government of India, Padmavati Yuva Pratibha Puraskar, Nritya Vilasini, Natya Bhramari, Subhadra Samman, Devdasi Ananya Nartaki Puraskar, Natyakala Chatura and Nritya Vidushi. She is also trained in sitar and Hindustani vocal music and is a budding filmmaker with training from the London Film Academy and Prague Film School. She is currently pursuing her master's in filmmaking from the London Film School, the United Kingdom. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ms. Prachi Hota.
Namaskar. The first item I will present today is a Pallavi. A Pallavi, which literally means to blossom, is a nritta or pure dance piece set to a specific rhythm cycle, which, much like the blossoming of a leaf bud, begins with slow lyrical movements and gathers speed to end in a crescendo. It not only takes you on a journey through the rhythm, grammar and technique of Odissi, but is also an elaboration of the rag that it is based on. The Pallavi I present today is based on rag Hamsadhani, choreographed by Guru Shri Kelucharan Mahapatra, presenting to you Hamsadhani Pallavi.
I'm not going to be able to do that. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, मधुराधिपते
The next performance is a Bharatanatyam recital by Anaina Pradeep. Anaina Pradeep is a disciple of Dr. Harshan Sebastian Antony. She has been learning Bharatanatyam from the age of 4. She is the winner of Kerala School Kalolsavam with the first place in Bharatanatyam at Calicut District. In addition to Bharatanatyam, Anaina also expresses her strong passion in other classical dance styles such as Kuchipudi, Mohiniyattam, etc. With the blessings of her parents and guru, she wishes to continue her artistic journey as much as her heart wishes. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Anaina Pradeep.
Namaste, Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. I'm Anaina Pradeep, coming from Kerala, disciple of Dr. Harshan sir. I'm performing Bharatanatyam based on Lord Krishna, Ragam, Simhendra Madhyamam, Talam, Adi. Thank you for Ada and Om School of Dance for this stage. Thank you.
Kanna karmekha varna vaarkudal vaadi Kanna karmekha varna vaarkudal vaadi
Thellangutta kathi kudakatha thingirna thongta Thi ta ka ya ka jam ta ka na ka jam ta hi ta tri kitta rakka da hi ta ka na ka jam hi ta ka na ka jam ta ka na ka jam ta hi ta tri kitta ta ka da hi ta ka na ka jam hi ta ka na ka jam ta ka na ka jam ta dhim tarigada daga daga dhi takka nakka jam dhi takka nakka jam takka nakka jam ta dhi tarigada daga dhi takka nakka jam dhi takka nakka jam takka nakka jam ta dhim tarigada daga daga dhi takka nakka jam dhi takka nakka jam takka nakka jam ta dhim tarigada daga dhi takka nakka jam ta dhi takkanam tadi janaku kundari takka jam tadi jakata tadi jana janaku kundari jam tadi takita jana tadi takita kukundari takita dhimmi tadi takita jam tadi kanam tadi ta takka dikku takka dikku tadi kita tum takka dikku tadi kita tum takka dikku tadi kita tum takka dikku takka 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 dikku tadi kita tum takka dikku takka dikku tadi kita tum takka dikku takka dikku tadi kita tum
கண்ணா கார்மேக வருந்தா வார்க்குடல்
Yeah.
ஆஷா அவதாரமிடுக்க மாதவே